Okay, so I just wanted to do a quick video on a way of decorating static dominant seventh chords and major chords, and ways in which you can join them up and even turn them into turnarounds and tunes. So hang on to your hats, this is going to be a little bit of a whistle-stop tour. I'll go quite fast. But the basic constituent of what I'm talking about is really simple, okay? So many of people watching might know, for instance, Django's Tiger in the key of G, which has a turnaround which goes like this: G slash B, B flat diminished, A minor 7, D 7, right? And this is a really common like swing era turnaround. It's not simply that tune, there's dozens of tunes that it appears in. By the way, apologies for any environmental noise, there's people working outside. But hopefully you can hear me. So this is very important for this is an important turnaround to know. But the best thing about it is it can be made to work both ways. So instead of going that way, you go turn it around. And usually when we do that, we usually get rid of the D7 and just go the A minor. You can do it both ways. And there's a bassy intro. It usually starts on one, actually. And so on, right? If I start on the root position one chord, and that's a whole load of riffs, for instance. Ya ba da bo ya boom. Ba-ba-da-ba-boom. Couldn't make it without you. Don't get around much anymore. And this relates to this. And intense. And with the extra note. Okay, so I mean, Alan Kingston calls them monk moves in his book, but they go way earlier than that. Monk himself was a student of James P. Johnson, the great stride pianist, and a lot of his music is based on, I can only describe it as subverting stride piano cliches, rhythmically and harmonically. And he was great at that. So, but these go back to the swing era, which is why I'm discussing them on this channel, really. So really, I think it helps if you think about this as a bass line rather than a chord progression. So for instance, if I'm going through a cycle of fourths, I can use the chord progression to join up, or the bass line, sorry, to join up the chord. So for, let's do, just because it happens to be set on the guitar quite nicely, let's do this in G, but it's like a rhythm changes bridge. So start on 3-7, which is B7, 6-7, E7, 2-7, A7, 5-7, D7, right? And we go, boom, 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 boom. And we're up a fourth. Up together with the chords. Let's do it down an octave. And that joins everything together, so we do two strums each, that'll work out rhythmically. Okay, so that's our B section of I Got Rhythm. Now you'll notice that is actually what they use in the bridge of Honeysuckle Rose, only it's inverted, so the melody goes. And again, he's got these things which you can use. That's another video in itself, but just to point that out. Okay, if we get to the A section rhythm changes, we can also use this to play that, because the A section rhythm changes is a turnaround. And the first four bars of rhythm changes is a simple turnaround. In this case, we're going to do it in G, just because gypsy jazz, okay? So in order to make that work, well, this might not work so well if we play our usual thing. So if we do this. This is Introduction to Hungaria, by the way. that's all made up. That's actually the introduction to Hungary, but a similar kind of vibe, right? We get to the G a little bit too early, so to kind of make sure, because it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, we want it to come back on 1 so we can go into the next bit of the song. So in order to do that, we need to add in 2 chords, and what we do is we just add in, on the way up, this lovely A flat diminished 7th, or G sharp diminished 7th, shall I say. And coming down, you got A minor 7, D 7, okay, and that's your rhythm changes, right? And then after that we have a very important turnaround, which is another turnaround, which I call either the 4 and back. You can also hear, it's also called Christoph. I call it 4 and back, so it goes to the 4 and back, okay? But there's loads of other names. Christoph is probably the most common one in gypsy jazz circles. And for this, we're going to go quite simply G, G7, C, and C sharp diminished. And then we're going to go, use our descending part of the turnaround. So, to get terms straight, this is an ascending turnaround. Okay, and the reason why I call it an ascending turnaround is we're going from a G major chord to an inversion of a G major chord. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and we reset on 1. This is a descending turnaround, it's the same job but goes down. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, so, and then we do our 4 and back, Christoph, and then descending. So the whole thing goes. Is one way of playing the rhythm changes, okay? And then the bridge goes again, same thing in a different position. And you can do another turnaround there. There's different types of turnarounds you can use, but I just wanted to sort of demonstrate how far you can go with one. Now, other songs do the same thing. One good example would be Ain't Misbehaving. By myself, no one to talk with. Sorry, that doesn't work because that doesn't fit the melody. No one to walk with, all by myself. No one to walk with, talk with, but I'm happy on the shelf. Okay, so what I did there is use a different turnaround, Christoph with a minor, C minor, because as you can hear, it doesn't work with the melody if I sing that. So if I change that, so we're playing an ascending turnaround. And then I do a move of Christoph to C and then C minor, then it will fit the melody. So you've got to use your ears, right? No one to walk with, all by myself. No one to talk with, but I'm happy on the shelf. Ain't misbehaving, I'm saving my love for you. Don't like that diminished there, so what I might do is I might do diminished. So I might do descending one, so. Misbehaving, I'm saving my love for you. And another descending. So they might go. No one to walk with, all by myself. No one to talk. No one. Sorry. Misbehaving, no one to walk with, all by myself. No one to talk with, but I'm happy on the shelf. Ain't misbehaving, I'm saving my love for you. There's another example. So what can we do with this in terms of soloing, right? Well, you can arpeggiate them. So if you're playing over like a boring old B7 chord for 2 bars in a rhythm changes head, and you've exhausted all the option of dominant stuff you can do. I mean, that's all dominant scale stuff, right? What you could do is you could actually use that chord progression to dress it up. So let's see if that works. So let's do the ascending one. Let's do the descending one first, so you go. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that's the sound. We go into that one. So then you go. Kind of cool, I think. let's try that again. Sorry, I'm not necessarily sure if I made that really clear in my playing. So. that's certainly introduced some movement there, okay? Same with the turnaround, so a bit of rhythm changes. We can go. That's pretty cool, isn't it? So I'm wanting a G diminished, and then. Or you could do it the other way around, go G. So what I did there is arpeggiated that. So that's G major. G sharp diminished. A minor 7. A flat 3 diminished, the old friend. And if you saw the substitutes that we have in our other video, you can maybe even do things like this. So. Let's see. So what I'm doing there is I'm playing a 1. I'm playing a G major, going to a flat 6 and a 5. Which is tune goes for that one. Anyway, it's loads of songs anyway, go flat 6-5. So sorry, the noises from the corridor are cracking me up. Anyway, that should be a source of interesting ideas, because I think if you're just playing like 1-6-2-5 all the time, I mean that's cool. It's very beboppy there, right? It's quite nice to have these other resources as well. And that's lovely. Now Django, often you'll hear Django often just playing on a major. Let's go like, I'm going to play the flat 3 diminished now. It's that lovely resolution. Quite unexpected. And you can use that as a portal for going. I mean, it's another move Django's very fond of. Semitone down, because of course you have a, as I pointed out by the video, if you have an undiminished chord, you can also relate it to a dominant seventh on a seventh, so you can go. And people will go, ooh, that's cool. A few ideas coming up, half step. What a different way to play rhythm changes. Anyway, I hope you find that interesting. I should probably go away and practice that now, because that's quite cool. I hope you enjoyed it anyway. Bye.